नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स, ब्रेन डिजीजेस, यस टुडे दिस इज़ अ टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन। वी विल फोकस ऑन द एस्ट्रोलॉजिकल पॉइंटर्स शोइंग दिस अफ्लिक्शन डिजीज इन ए बस चार्ट। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द एस्ट्रोलॉजिकल डायग्नोसिस, आई थिंक दिस टॉपिक नीड अ लिटल इंट्रोडक्शन। In medical terms, lot of names have been given to these brain-related diseases like multiple sclerosis, MS, Alzheimer, brain cancer, brain hemorrhage, etc. But one thing is common, and that is all are related to the afflicted functioning of the brain. Broadly, medical researchers define it as the faulty communication system of the brain nerves. Saturn is the main cork of nerves, air, vayu, one of the five elements, panch bhutas, which moves through nerves in the whole body. In other words, Saturn being main cork of nerves and the air element helps the other four elements to flow in the body for different purposes. It is Vayana Vayu, one of the panch prana energies responsible for action and expression. The communication process of the nerves from head to the toe. Disturbances or damages only comes when the mind nerves are in excess or short of vayu. In other words, either the Saturn is too strong or too weak in a chart. And this quality of Saturn, air, gives space to other malefic forces to function. Since air is mobile, it controls the arising of our thoughts. It also controls the entire nerve system of the body, including the brain. Due to the affliction of this Vayu Tattva, especially brain nerves becomes very sensitive, and any malefic approach at this time makes this disease to manifest. For a moment, leaving aside status of the Saturn in a chart, being a physical tattva planet, it may not be directly so harmful, but its element air and its karka houses, 6th, 8th and 12th, in the manifestation of this disease surely plays a strong role. The involvement of other malefics, GK, Janati Karka in the Charkarkas, Gulika as invisible poison toxin force, and Rahu as an obstructor seems to be more responsible for damaging the nerve system. Poison affects through nerve system, and any obstruction in the nerves is similar to the poison. And this theory confirmed in the recent medical study. Researchers found a highly toxic molecule, NKG2C, is responsible for harming the brain tissues of the MS patients. Before proceeding further, one thing more need to be clear. Brain is the most complicated part of the body, and that is why its related diseases are also known as the most complicated one. So when we are discussing about its indication in a chart, we should understand that these diseases are not limited to only one, like MS. There are so many other diseases related to the brain, and it could be any one of them. This disease affliction is related to brain. So for diagnosis purposes, ascendant lagna and ascendant lord, lagna lord, should be taken as a focal point. To make application more precise, we are taking here lagna nakshatra lord as prime dispositor, but at the same time not ignoring the rashi lagna lords absolutely. I have also found such cases where lagna and lagna lord both are not involved directly, but the strength of lagna is almost nil and affliction giving planets are too strong. So strength of lagna and lagna lord should always be kept in the mind as a prime factor. One can find such charts also where the afflictions are clearly visible, but the person is living a normal life due to the strength of lagna and lagna lord. No doubt these type of person seems living an unafflicted life, but this malefic influence still reflects in their personality. Due to the poisonous effect, the brain nerves becomes very sensitive and they people live a highly tensed and stressful life. Now, the key role players. Point number one. When Atamkarka makes some relation with the Lagna or the Lagna Lord in a chart, it gives an ability of self-realization to the native. It is called activation, Atambodh, to achieve the goal, the real purpose, desire of the soul to take this birth. How to achieve that goal, by free will or bondage, depends on the karma debt. Only those persons having this yoga in their chart knows the true definition of Atam Jnana, as their souls are activated and awakened. On the same principle, in the Charakarka scheme, GK, Janatikarka, is known for rivals, strife, crisis, diseases, and even the death. When it makes any relation with Lagna or Lagna Lord, it makes a strong Duryoga and gives a malefic impact for which it is known. Though GK stands for malefic significance, but it also gives strength to fight with the enemies and odds. But when it makes negative approach with the malefic Gulika, it creates horrible situation. Point number two, Gulika as an upagraha, an invisible force, is considered as the strongest malefic and poisonous. Gulika Nakshatra is known as a carrier of poison which a native have to bear in his life. 1st, 10th and 19th Nakshatra to Gulika Nakshatra means the same lord of Gulika, and 14th Nakshatra from Gulika known as Parmana Gulika, all are considered equally poisonous. The malefic blemish comes on the planets occupying the trinal nakshatra to Gulika and the Gulika nakshatra lord. They are known as Fatal and Marka. And its any relation with Lagna or Lagna lord gives a strong personality disorder due to the poison they occupy. Point number 3, role of Rahu as a natural obstructor is also well known. Good or bad, its nature is enhancement and mostly on the evil side. Point number 4, Saturn, the main significator of nerves and the air element, its weakness or the strength, both are dangerous, which are misused by the Rahu and the Gulika to work according to their significances. Too windy or fast and too slow are stopped. Both the stages of air are harmful for every living being. Once the indication of the disease are confirmed in the Rashi chart, we can also this affliction verify the results in the D6 chart also. Coming to example charts. Case number 2. Lagna Nakshatra, Vishakha, Lord Jupiter. This Jupiter is combust and can say it's weak. Janati Karaka, Venus, is also the Rashi Lagna lord and placed in the Lagna itself. Gulika in the Hast Nakshatra, Lord Moon, placed in the 7th house and having aspect on the Lagna. Rashi Lagna lord Venus is in the close conjunction with Saturn in Swati, 4th Pada. Nakshatra of Rahu. Other indications. Gulika and Mars placed in the same nakshatra and Pada are placed in the 12th house of expenses, hospitalization, coming to the D6 chart. These two, Mars and Gulika, are along with Rahu and Ketu. These four objects are placed in the 6th house of Roga, illnesses, having aspect on the 12th bhava of expenses. This way, the affliction or can say disease is confirmed in the three steps. GK and Gulika, Gulika Lord in the Rashi chart and its confirmation in the D6 chart. Next, case number 3. Lagna Nakshatra is Anuradha, Lord Saturn. And it is loser in the fight with Venus. Both are at the 23 degree, placed in the 12th house of expenses. GK Janatikarka is Jupiter, which is having aspect on the Lagna. Lagna Nakshatra, Lord Saturn, is also in the GK Jupiter Nakshatra Vishakha. Rashi Lagna Lord Mars is also the Gulika Lord, highly malefic. In this way, both the Lagna Lords, Nakshatra as well as Rashi, are afflicted. In the D6 chart, this Mars, Gulika Lord, is placed in the 6th house of illnesses. And GK Jupiter is in the 12th house of hospitalization, having aspect on the 8th house. Next example, case number 4. Lagna Nakshatra is Anuradha and its Lord is placed in the 8th power. Chatter. Rashi Lagna Lord Mars is placed in the 12th house and having strength of only AV 2 points. GK is Mercury, which is also in the Anuradha and placed in the Lagna itself and having a negative strength of AV 5 points. This Mercury is also the Lord of Gulika, which is in the Ashlesha, the mysterious Nakshatra. Rahu also plays in Mercury's other nakshatra, Jyeshta, in trinal to Gulika. On the whole, Mercury becomes the most malefic planet, harming the native and making the Lagna most malefic. As Mercury is the main focus, we will check its status in the D6 chart. And it is placed in the 11th house. All gains will Arudha of 8th house. A8. Is it the gain of strife? So this way, in all the cases, we will check affliction in the Rashi chart, which further can be confirmed in the D6 chart by the viewers themselves. Next chart, case number 6. Lagna Nakshatra, Magha, Lord Ketu. Mars Jayanti Karka is having aspect on both the Lagna Lords, Rashi and Nakshatra, which are Ketu and Sun. This Mars is also the Gulika Lord, so it becomes strong malefic. Gulika is in Mrikshira, Mars Nakshatra, and Atamkarak Saturn is in Chitra, Mars Nakshatra, in trine to Gulika. AK involvement shows affliction at the soul level. Next, case number 8. Lagna Nakshatra Vishakha, Lord Jupiter, which is also the Gulika Lord. Rahu in GK Mars Nakshatra, having aspect on Lagna and both the Lagna Lords. Gulika Nakshatra Punarvasu, Lord Jupiter, is the trinal to the Lagna Nakshatra. Lagna and four planets in Vishakha, Jupiter, all are afflicted. Additional, Saturn is having aspect on the Lagna and GK Mars placed in the 12th house. Next, case number 9. Lagna Nakshatra Mula, Lord Ketu, which is placed in the 6th house of Roga. Lagna Rashi Lord Jupiter itself is Janati Karaka, GK. Gulika in Anuradha, Lord Saturn, is placed in the 7th house and having aspect on the Lagna. GK Jupiter aspecting Gulika Lord Saturn. So Gulika becomes more malefic. In addition to this, Rahu is placed in the 12th house along with the Gulika. Affliction proved. Next, case number 12. Lagna Nakshatra Chitra, Lord Mars. GK Saturn and Gulika both are in Swati Nakshatra, Lord Rahu. So in this way, Rahu becomes strongly poisoned. Lagna Nakshatra Lord Mars, GK Saturn and Gulika Lord Rahu all are in the trinal nakshatras with the same nakshatra Lord Rahu. Gulika Nakshatra Lord Rahu is having aspect on the Lagna Nakshatra Lord Mars. Saturn Janati Karaka coenjoined with the Gulika is having aspect on the Rashi Lagna Lord Mercury and the 8th house. This person was remained bedridden for a long, long time. Next, case number 13. Nakshatra of Lagna, Dhanishta, Lord Mars. जनती कारक वीनस इज प्लेस्ड इन द मृगशिरा नक्षत्र ऑफ मार्स. जनती कारक वीनस is having aspect on the Lagna Lord Saturn, which is placed in the 12th house. Gulika Lord Sun is having aspect on the Lagna. Jupiter in Gulika Nakshatra, Kritika, is co-joining Gulika with the aspect on the Lagna. So, disease confirmed. Case number 15. Lagna Nakshatra Uttarashada, Sun, placed in the Maran Karak Sthana of 12th house, can be considered weak. Lagna Lord Jupiter is also Janati Karaka and placed in the 7th house, having full aspect on the Lagna. Saturn and Gulika both are in the Shatbisha Rahu Nakshatra. Saturn and Rahu both are having aspect on the Lagna Nakshatra Lord Sun. Case number 16. Lagna Nakshatra Ashlesha, Lord Mercury. GK Mars is in the 7th house, having aspect on the Lagna. Gulika in Magha. Lord Ketu, Gulika Lord Ketu, conjoined Lagna Nakshatra Lord Mercury in the Anuradha Nakshatra. This person was on the wheelchair for the long time. Case number 17. Lagna Nakshatra Punarvasu, Jupiter. Janati Karaka Mars and Gulika both are in the Uttara Bhadrapad Saturn Nakshatra. This GK Mars is having aspect on the Lagna. And Gulika Lord Saturn is having aspect on the Lagna Nakshatra Lord Jupiter, which is placed in the 6th house of Roga. In addition to this, Rahu is also having aspect on the Lagna. Malefic influence is clearly visible. This was the case of MS patient. Case number 18. Lagna Nakshatra Chitra, Lord Mars. Janati Karaka Moon is placed in Uttara Bhadrapad and Gulika in Pushya. Both are Saturn's trinal nakshatras. Yantikaraka moon is placed in the seventh house with having the aspect on the Lagna. Gulika Lord Saturn is aspecting Lagna Nakshatra Lord Mars. In addition to this, Rahu is placed in the Lagna and Saturn in the eighth house. Confirm. Next case number is 22nd. Lagna Nakshatra, Pushya, Lord Saturn. Janati Karaka Sun, Gulika, Mercury, Venus and Rahu all are placed in Ashwini Ketu Nakshatra. In this way, all becomes poisonous. Rahu aspect on Lagna Nakshatra Lord Saturn. Note here, involvement of Rahu as Atam Karaka indicate affliction at the soul level. Next case number 25th. Lagna Nakshatra, Mrikshira, Lord Mars. Mars itself is Janati Karaka and placed in the 12th house with Gulika and Lagna Rashi Lord Mercury. Gulika in Rohini, Nakshatra of Moon. Saturn and Ketu are placed in the trinal Nakshatra Shravan to Gulika, which is placed in the 8th house. Rahu is aspecting the 8th house. This was also the critical case of MS disease. Next chart number 26. Lagna Nakshatra, Moola, Lord Ketu. Janati Karaka Mercury is also placed in Moola, Ketu Nakshatra, in the Lagna. Gulika is in the Kritika, Sun Nakshatra. Also in the Moola, placed in the Lagna. Addition to this, Rahu and Mars both are placed in the Anuradha Nakshatra fourth pada, in fight in the 12th house, aspect on the Ketu in the 6th house. Addition to this, Saturn is placed in the 7th house and having aspect on the Lagna. Also, a critical case of MS disease. Next chart, case number 27. Lagna Nakshatra Bharani, Lord Venus. Janati Karaka Mars is Rashi Lagna Lord and placed in the Lagna itself. Gulika in Vishakha, Lord Jupiter, which is also the 12th Lord and placed in the Lagna. Addition to this, Saturn is also having aspect on the Lagna. Also, a critical case of MS. Next case number is 13. Lagna Nakshatra, Vishakha, Jupiter Nakshatra, Janati Karaka Saturn placed in the 7th house, having aspect on the Lagna. Gulika is placed in the Moon Nakshatra Hast, also in Lagna. Mars in Rohini, a trinal nakshatra of Gulika Lord, having aspect on the Lagna. Lagna strength is 0, 2 weak. Addition to this, Rahu is having aspect on the Janati Karaka Saturn. Case number 34. Lagna Nakshatra Jyeshta, Lord Mercury. Janati Karaka Jupiter is placed in the Lagna, afflicting Lagna Lord Mars. Both are in the Anuradha Nakshatra of Saturn. Gulika is placed in the Magha Nakshatra, Lord Ketu. Venus in Mula, Moon in Ashwini. All are in the Gulika Lord Ketu's Nakshatra, becomes all malefics. In addition to this, debilitated Saturn is placed in the 6th house of diseases with the Moon. Case number 39. Lagna Nakshatra Uttara Falguni, Lord Sun. Moon is Janati Karaka as well as Gulika Lord, as Gulika is in the Hast. So Moon become most malefic. Mars is placed in the Shravan Nakshatra, Moon Nakshatra, and this is in trine to the Gulika. This malefic Mars is having aspect on the Lagna Nakshatra Lord Sun and Lagna Lord Mercury. Rahu, which is also placed in the Shravan Nakshatra of Moon, having aspect on the Lagna. Addition, Saturn is having aspect on the Lagna Nakshatra Lord Sun. Case number 41. Lagna Nakshatra Uttara Falguni, Lord Sun, which is placed in the 12th house with the Rahu in the Maran Karakstana. Moon is Yanti Karka and the Gulika Lord. Both so become most malefic. And this moon is placed in the Lagna. Moon is conjoining Mars, Mercury and Gulika. All are in Lagna. Severe affliction on the Lagna. Next example, case number 45. Lagna Nakshatra Punarvasu. Jupiter's Nakshatra. In this chart, Mars is Janti Karka and having aspect on the Lagna. This GK Mars and Gulika both are in the Uttarabhadrapada. Saturn Nakshatra. So Mars become more malefic. Gulika Lord Saturn is having aspect on the Jupiter, which is the Lagna Nakshatra Lord. In addition to this, Rahu placed in the seventh house is also having aspect on the Lagna. Case number 48. Lagna Nakshatra Purvashada. Nakshatra of Venus. Rahu is Janti Karka, placed in the seventh house with Saturn, and both are having aspect on the Lagna. Gulika is placed in the Repti, Mercury Nakshatra, that is also placed in the Lagna. Sun and Mars both are in the Gulika's trinal nakshatra Jyeshta, lorded by Mercury, and in the 12th house. Case number 50. Lagna Nakshatra Magha Lord Ketu. Mars is Janti Karka, conjoined with 12th Lord Moon and placed in the 12th house. Gulika is in Bharani, Lord Venus, which is placed in the 8th house with Rashi Lagna Lord Sun. Rahu is in Purvashada, a trinal nakshatra to the Gulika Nakshatra, same Lord Venus. Rahu is having aspect on the Lagna and the nakshatra Lagna Lord Ketu. Case number 54. Lagna Nakshatra Punarvasu Lord Jupiter. This is also the Gulika Nakshatra Lord. Venus Janati Karka is placed in the Lagna. Saturn and Gulika in the Punarvasu, same Jupiter Nakshatra, Saturn become more malefic. and this Saturn is placed in the Lagna. Gulika Lord Jupiter is having aspect on the 8th house, its debilitation sign, and the 12th house. Also, a severe case . Next case number 55. Lagna Nakshatra, Purva Bhadrapad, Jupiter. This Jupiter itself is Janati Karaka. Gulika is in Revati, Mercury Nakshatra. And expecting Lagna Lord Jupiter. This Mercury is Atam Karaka and placed in the 8th house. This affliction is at the soul level. Mercury conjoined with Venus and Mars, which are in the fight mode. 8th house is heavily afflicted. In addition to this, Rahu from the 7th house is also having aspect on the Lagna. Now, let us see the strength. Lagna, AV2, Jupiter, AV4, Saturn, 0, and Mercury, AV7. The afflicted planets are having more strength, and the Lagna is weak. Next case number 58. Lagna Nakshatra, Jyeshtha Lord Mercury. Janati Karaka and Gulika Lord. Rahu is placed in the 9th house, having aspect on the Lagna. Jupiter is in Shatbisha. Trinal Nakshatra to Gulika Nakshatra Swati, having aspect on the 8th and 12th house. In addition to this, Rahu is having aspect on the Saturn, Atam Karaka, affliction at the soul level, and this Saturn is having aspect on the 12th house of hospitalization and the deep sleep. This is the case of a person who died after remains in coma for 4 months. Case number 59. Lagna Nakshatra, Uttara Bhadrapad, Lord Saturn. Janati Karaka Jupiter is placed in the Lagna. And this Jupiter is also the Rashi Lagna Lord. Jupiter is having aspect on the Lagna Nakshatra Lord Saturn. Gulika is in Chitra and the Lord Mars is placed in the 7th house, having aspect on the Lagna. This Mars is also Atamkarka. This affliction is at the soul level. So friends, that's all about the brain diseases. I have tried to explain the pointers with reference to so many charts, just to make it easy to understand for all. In the next video, we will work on the timing of this malefic effect, manifestation of the disease. Meantime, work on some charts and stay tuned for the coming video. Thanks for joining me. Take care. Bye.